Dear students, today we will start Kirchhoff's rule. What is this? Kirchhoff's rules. What is the use of this Kirchhoff's rules? Now we have to see. So, before the holidays, we have completed cells connected in series, cells connected in parallels. We have completed. So now today we have to see what is Kirchhoff's rules. Now, already we know Ohm's law is applicable for a simple circuit. When there is a complex circuits, in case of a complex circuits, we cannot apply the Ohm's law. For that particular case, we require the Kirchhoff's rule. So Kirchhoff's rules, or it is also called as the Kirchhoff's laws. This is applied for both AC and DC circuit. Some terms are there in the Kirchhoff's rules which you have to understand first of all before starting that. So first of all, you have to understand that what is electrical network. What is electrical network? Now, network means what? Network means arrangement of circuit elements such as resistors, cells. Okay. It is a complicated arrangement. Electrical network means what? It is the complicated arrangement of circuit such as resistors and cells. Now, when it is a complicated arrangement, then comes the junction. What is junction? Second point is the junction, or it is also called as node. Okay, junction or node in electrical network. So now we have to see what is junction or node. Junction means it is a point in an electrical network at which more than two current meets at a point. जंक्शन का मतलब क्या है? जंक्शन का मतलब है उस पॉइंट को जंक्शन कहते हैं जहाँ पर एक से ज़्यादा करंट मीट होता है. ओके, सो इट इज ए पॉइंट इन एन इलेक्ट्रिकल नेटवर्क at which more than two currents meets. When the more than two current meet, that is called as what? Junction or a node. Now, these are the small definitions we are studying for the Kirchhoff's rules. So before studying the Kirchhoff's rules, we must know what is electrical network, what is junction or node. Next comes the electrical loop. Electrical loop or mesh. Now, loop means what? Loop means it is a closed path. Loop means it is a closed path for circulation of a current in an electrical network. Loop kise kehte hain? Loop ya mesh kise kahenge? It is the closed path for circulation of current. In an इलेक्ट्रिकल नेटवर्क, और एक बार समझ लो, व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रिकल लूप और मेश? इट इज द क्लोज्ड पाथ फॉर सर्कुलेशन ऑफ करंट इन एन इलेक्ट्रिकल नेटवर्क. नेटवर्क के अंदर जो क्लोज्ड पाथ रहेगा, उस क्लोज्ड पाथ में जो करंट का सर्कुलेशन रहेगा, उसे हम क्या कहेंगे? इलेक्ट्रिकल लूप कहेंगे या मेश कहेंगे. नाउ ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दीज थ्री पॉइंट्स, नाउ वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट द किरचॉफ्स रूल. देर आर टू रूल्स ऑफ किरचॉफ्स. फर्स्ट रूल इज कॉल्ड एज किरचॉफ्स जंक्शन रूल. फर्स्ट रूल इज कॉल्ड एज व्हाट? किरचॉफ्स जंक्शन रूल फॉर इलेक्ट्रिकल नेटवर्क. नाउ दिस जंक्शन रूल, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज के सी एल. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज वॉट? के सी एल, किरचॉफ्स करंट रूल. ओके ओके, के सी एल और के सी आर इट इज. वॉट इट मीन्स किरचॉफ जंक्शन रूल फॉर द इलेक्ट्रिकल नेटवर्क? वॉट दिस सेज? दिस सेज दैट सपोज द स्टेटमेंट विल टेक फर्स्ट द सम ऑफ वॉट इट सेज द सम ऑफ द करंट्स. द सम ऑफ द करंट्स एंटरिंग द जंक्शन. Entering the junction is equal to the sum of the current leaving the junction. What this rule says, the sum of the currents entering the junction is equal to the sum of the currents leaving the junction. Now suppose, for this we'll take consider one explanation. Suppose this is I1, O is the point, this O point is the junction point. This arrow mark shows that current is coming at this particular junction. Another current is there, I2, and another current is there, I3, and this is I4. What is happening in this? O is the junction point. The sum of the currents entering the junction, I1 and I2, are entering the junction, and I3 and I4 are leaving the junction. So what it says, from this figure what we conclude, O is the junction point. At the junction point O, I1 and I2 are the incoming current or entering the current, and I3 and I4 are what? Outgoing current or leaving the current. So if we say that I1 and I2 are the current entering the junction O, and
I3 and I4 are the currents leaving the junction. Leaving the junction O. Then from this rule what we'll write? From Kirchhoff's junction rule, what we'll write? I1 plus I2 is equal to I3 plus I4. So from this what we conclude? I1 and I2 are the incoming current, I3 and I4 are the outgoing current. So from the first Kirchhoff's junction rule what we conclude? That the incoming current in a junction is equal to outgoing current or leaving the current in the junction. So this is the first rule, I1 plus I2 is equal to I3 plus I4. So this indicates what? Kirchhoff's first rule, or it is called as a Kirchhoff's current rule. Okay, now we'll go for the second rule, that is Kirchhoff's loop rule. Kirchhoff's loop rule. Now Kirchhoff's loop rule, here it indicates what? Here there is a loop. Loop means what? We'll consider one figure here. You consider that A, here the current is coming, here is a cell whose EMF is E1, current is passing through it, through the resistor at the point B. And this is A, this is B, and there is another cell which is also passing through a resistor, and A, B, C, D is a loop. This is a closed loop. A, B, C, D is a closed loop, and E1 is the first cell, E2 is the EMF of the second cell, this is R1, this is R2. Because of the first cell, I1 amount of current is flowing through the circuit. Similarly, for the second cell, I2 amount of current is flowing through the circuit from this loop. So now loop has become A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D is the loop. So what it says, this loop rule says that the algebraic sum of IR, I means current, R means resistor, the algebraic sum of product of current and resistance is equal to the algebraic sum of the EMFs in an electrical loop. Here how many EMFs are there? Two EMFs are there, E1 and E2. And current and resistance, combination of current and resistance will become what? Product of current and resistance. I1, R1, I2, R2. So from this, what we conclude? Statement. What is the statement from this? The statement of Kirchhoff's loop rule is the algebraic sum of the IR. IR means what? Current and resistance. Product. This is the product. Algebraic sum of IR product is equal to the algebraic sum of the EMFs in electrical loop. This is the statement. So how will you write, how will you apply to this? Kirchhoff's loop will, when we apply, so on applying loop rule, what we'll get? Loop rule to ABCD. ABCD is the loop. What we will get? We will get product of I1, R1. When we come here, we are coming in this direction. Current is in this direction. Since opposite direction is there, so here current will become what? Minus of I2, R2, which is equal to E1. When we are passing from here to here, lower potential to higher potential, so it will come positive. And when it comes here, here will get first positive and then negative, so minus of E2. So this is the rule for the Kirchhoff's loop rule. Okay, so in the second video we'll see the in detail.